When you first dig on the internet, you're gonna see all kinds of crazy theories. Worms, Martians, Columbula, chemtrails.
Few patients go public with a diagnosis of Morgellons disease because of the ridicule and doubt that can follow. One celebrity who has spoken about having Morgellons is singer Joni Mitchell, who was recently hospitalized in Los Angeles.
See, I feel like digging that out right now. It's that uncomfortable.
Several of my patients would have these strange fibers coming out of them. Lesions that would spontaneously appear and very slowly heal, filaments, black specks coming out of the skin, joint pain, fatigue, sleep disturbance, brain fog, the list goes on.
Morgellons disease is a delusion.
Morgellons is a real disease, there's no question about it.
You can only have so much skin shedding and like bleeding before somebody notices, but you have to make something up or say it's something else because there's no such thing as Morgellons disease.
I made the mistake of saying Morgellons. The ER physician actually escorted me out. My discharge instructions were, quit picking at yourself.
It takes tremendous courage to look at a situation and really ask yourself if you're being delusional.
This is what mental illness looks like right here.
Borrelia seems to be present in 100% of the Morgellons samples that we've looked at.
Our conclusion is that Morgellons disease might be a manifestation of Lyme disease.
Don't jump from, hey, she's got a little spot on her, to, here, take a freaking happy pill. That's what you do, and you shouldn't be in medicine, bubba.
Morgellons and delusions of parasitosis are exactly the same thing.
And we need to educate young doctors that Morgellons disease is real.
You think that all those labs are wrong?
Oh, obviously they're wrong. It's ridiculous.
Our right to decent patient care is real.
He would say, I will get Morgellons disease recognized in my lifetime or I will have died trying. And he died trying, but I'm gonna do it.
Our suffering is real.
The dog in your house.
Oh, good boy.
Wagging its tail, licking your face, and how good that makes you feel.
Oh my God.
It's incredible. I've set my life up to be a veterinarian that deals with terminal cases from all over the world.
We've got increased rates of cancer, diabetes, you name it. We see the worst of the worst here.
Most of the animals already had third, fourth, and fifth opinions. We are their very last hope.
I don't want to lose her.
I was working in conventional veterinary medicine. I became a very sickly person. My doctor recommended antibiotics and long-acting steroids that got me searching for answers conventional medicine didn't offer.
When somebody first brought up a holistic vet to me, I was like, so they can take grass and rub it all over my dog?
I've been criticized. Snake oil salesman, charlatan.
The holistic or alternative say, I don't want to do anything conventional. Or the conventional vet who says, absolutely no alternatives.
They're all coming in after being on drugs. They want to know how you made this dog better.
Integrative medicine works.
I'm here to destroy this guy. He just did the biggest miracle of my entire career. I actually fainted.
Whether you're a person, an animal, it doesn't matter. Being in the hospital sucks.
You're okay.
They don't understand what's happening to them. They're just trusting us.
Coming from a traditional background, I can't even conceive of this kind of success.
With cryosurgery, we actually freeze the tumor. Advise it's time to work on the immune system.
People say, do you think it's working? Yeah, he had 5 weeks to live 2 years ago.
He is fabulous.
If I gave up knowing that this can be done, that would kill me.
Good boy.
It's a whole new process of thinking.
Ready?
Now here's a little story that I got to tell about three bad brothers that you know so well. It started way back in history with that rock,
MCA,
and me, Mike D. Hello everyone!
What we're gonna
gonna do right here is go back, way back, back into time.
The Beastie Boys.
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 In the early 80s, everyone in our scene was in a band.
We wanted to be rappers so bad, but we were mediocre at best.
Now hit it hot, just don't stop.
Most rappers hold their rhymes in little pieces of paper, right?
We went from being famous in a 14-block radius to being on tour with Madonna and Rick Rubin.
The shows kept getting bigger and bigger.
We morphed from making fun of party bros to actually becoming those dudes.
We were burning out.
I just didn't even recognize the person that I had become at that point.
Yo, hold up. It's not over yet. Go.
There's not that many times in your life when you realize you're in a new chapter.
The Beastie Boys are back after a six-year absence.
We changed how we wanted to be as people and friends.
We got inspired, and while experimenting, we found our voice.
Really? High five?
Yeah, it's coming back, Adam. It's coming back.
Adam Yauch was the driving force. The one that not only gets themselves going and doing great things, but says we should all do this. Yauch was that type of friend. Yauch, Mike, and I have spent more time with each other than with our own families.
It's not like all of it was easy or highlight-filled, but who gets to work every day with their two best friends?
Why do we paint?
We paint because we have no choice.
We're talking with the American painter Richard Smithson and his wife, Claire. So what's next for you two?
Well, I create the art. She creates the rest of our life.
I love you.
The things I love the most about him still love his arrogance, his ego.
It's not a painting unless you leave a piece of yourself on the canvas.
He's been behaving so strangely for months.
What are you doing?
I don't think I'm sure what this is all about.
They're honoring you. You're getting an award.
I didn't know what to say. I didn't write anything down. All I can tell you is what's going on with me.
It never occurred to you?
He'll have these moments where he's just so himself. And then he vanishes.
Damn it!
Richard, look at me. I do want to help you.
You never became a painter.
Because I was too busy supporting your career.
It's very hard to look inside and paint what's all gone.
Are you painting again? You were always such a sensitive artist. I always envied your decision to step away.
You don't see anything different?
I see something different, okay. Richard, and it's you.
You can't paint. You never really tried. Paint what breaks your heart. What you can't get back.
Well, look who's here, my two favorite brothers. Where's my money?
That's what we wanted to discuss with you.
You got three options. You can miraculously pull the money that you owe me out of your ass in the next 10 seconds. Option number two, you go with my boy Joey here on a simple house call.
I'd love to hear the third option.
Barry owes my old man 80 dimes. Shoot him. Come on, shoot him.
This wasn't part of the deal. If you want to wipe your debt clean, end it!
What?
No!
Put the word out on the street. Cash reward. Anybody brings me those degenerates.
End this chaos.
Back door now! Go!
Are you seriously standing in my doorway right now?
Tony Davalo wants us dead.
One less Jackie Callahan in the world might not be such a bad thing.
I think you miss me.
It never ends with you two.
I don't want to be here. I want to go home.
It's not safe. I say we go on the defensive. Get them before they get us. It's offense, idiot. Offensive.
I want this done in the most painful way.
It will be handled clean. No mess.
You could be a little messy. We call an apex predator.
How long do we let this go on?
To the end.
Because of you,
the Davalo name dies with me.
Oh, look who it is. The Irish twins.
Don't you two owe me money?
Get in line.
You have the right to remain silent.
Aren't you trained for shit like this?
Let's do this.
What the?
Kareem needs to go by a friend's house after school.
And he asked that you pick him up.
When my mom dated this one guy, we became BFFs.
You were BFFs with a grown-ass man? There's literally documentaries on Netflix about why that's so sick and fucked up.
I think that's a difference.
You expect us to be BFFs? Fuck out of my face, man.
Good talk.
Welcome back to my channel. Remember when I told you about that white cop who was humping my mom? Well, now you see what happens when you fuck with me. Pig stuck his dick in the wrong blanket.
Hey, Stan, that you've been talking about the deal.
Holy shit.
Hey, who's back there?
Green, run! Go! Get in!
Back up, yo. Your dick is rubbing against my ass.
Well, then turn towards me.
I don't want to rub dicks either.
Is everything okay?
This all started when your son tried to have me killed because he saw us having sex this morning.
Now the most dangerous drug dealers in Detroit are trying to kill us.
Oh, what did I date a white guy? My friend Sharon was right. All of you are fucked up.
Go, go, go! It's the police!
Just don't touch shit.
No fingerprints. Thank you.
Oh, no! The fight's out!
Yeah, this is my fucking scene right here.
Tell your mom we went to Chuck E. Cheese.
To be honest, women scare the shit out of me. I mean, where do you even start?
Excuse me. My friend here would like to practice talking with a lady.
Tell me about yourself.
I was born and raised in Detroit, and I have an associate's degree in biology, and I'm studying to be a veterinarian.
How much you look at your...
No.
Sometimes I wish my family died in a house fire, except for me, you know. And then everyone put money in a fund for poor baby Susan. Wouldn't that be great?
Yeah.
Is there anything else Kmart should know about you before we conclude this interview?
I'm very creative, and I can do percentages in my head.
I see you left the box unchecked for have you ever been convicted of a crime?
Intern.
Your father could never keep a job either.
Hey, Susan, want to hear a joke?
I don't. I'm late for work.
Where are you working now?
Kind of all around, you know, party planning and, you know, like that.
You kicked me out of my apartment.
I gave you like 9 warnings.
What are you looking to get for this today?
$20,000?
Whoa. This is employees only.
You're supposed to use gloves when scooping ice.
I was just wondering if I could stay with you guys.
What the? What is wrong with it?
I'm sorry, I got distracted, and next thing I know, I'm banging into the back of you.
Oh, yeah, I know you want it!
You work here?
I own
it. Oh, my God.
This could be what I've been waiting for. Someone to take care of me for a change. Can I borrow your Spanx for tonight?
No, the boys made eye masks out of them.
We're all going on a trip. We're taking you to Niagara Falls.
Niagara Falls is on my vision board.
You're not going.
Susan, did you get me a present?
Oh, yes, yeah, sweetie. I got you. Here's some crazy glue.
Cool.
Yeah, go crazy.
You are unbelievable.
Looks like love is finally found.
He's a criminal! Move, move, move!
I wanna know what love is!
Justice!
Oh, oh my God!
I want to
show me!
I wanna feel!
I don't think he's a cop.
He's fucking dead!
We know he's dead, but we didn't kill him.
He liked to report a murder or whatever.
We didn't murder anybody!
1, 2, 3, go!
No.
Jabron! Okay, the guy's name is Jabron.
Run, Leilani!
And the girl's name's actually Leilani.
Shit.
She's running too now. Kind of slowly, because she's wearing heels that look actually amazing.
We have to go to the police, because we have nothing to hide.
Why did you run from the scene of the crime?
Good question, officer.
That's me covering up my body cam, so I can beat your ass.
We're so fucked!
We just need to find the guy the police are looking for.
Do you suggest we actually go out there and solve a
murder?
It's locked. Did you think it was one of those men-only doors? All we need is a name, and then we're in the clear.
Hey man, it's been a minute.
Who the fuck are you?
Who do you work for? You little bitch. You little beanbag ballless bitch.
Yeah. You think about your grandma and that furry beanbag bitch.
What?
These people are super dangerous and they're really powerful.
Stop!
This is some Handmaid's Tale bullshit.
We have imposters.
Oh no, imposters. That sucks.
Everyone unmask yourself.
Oh shit. Nobody else took their masks off.
I'm gonna give you Lovebirds a choice. What's behind this door or bacon grease to the fight?
I don't want grease on my face.
Is it gonna shit on me?
Oh, take the grease.
Free up my love.
What's the last thing you remember, Danny? He said we had to run. The reason you survived is because you're a very uncommon girl. You're not alone. Not anymore. Do you know what mutants are? Would anyone like to share their first time? Rain?
I was 13. I thought it was a dream. I just lost control.
Sam?
I started panicking. People got hurt.
Roberto?
My girlfriend had a partner.
Ileana?
I killed 18 men, one by one. It's a cage.
It's important we find out your power so we can help you get better.
I saw something I don't think she wanted me to see. I
takes your greatest fear and makes you live through it until it kills you. Who's there? We can get out of this together.
There once was a woman, made of moonlight and teeth. She would roam in the woods, searching for something, hunting.
And he just kept telling me, you are perfect. You are accepted.
Oh, my shepherd, I need a deeper experience with you than I ever had before.
So beautiful, just like your mother's.
Come down upon me and fill me with yourself.
Let us pray. My wives, you all came to me broken by a cruel world. I took every one of you in. I sacrificed my life for you. I gave you daughters and sisterhood and life. Let us reflect on our blessings.
Yes, my shepherd.
You think that because you haven't had your time yet, that makes you special. Prepare yourself, child. Our great shepherd won't be so sweet on you then. I'll be seeing you when the blood comes to you.
As I went down in the valley to pray, studying about that good old way and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way.
Shala, what happened?
Oh, sisters, let's go down.
It's worse than punishment.
Let's go down, on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down.
I am relying on you, Shala. Of all my children, you're the purest in your faith.
Are you Peter?
That depends who's asking.
Peter!
We are gathered here today to join Bea and Thomas in holy matrimony.
You're taking this so well.
He's a good man.
You hated this guy.
We've grown very close.
Welcoming a new parent.
Not that close.
A father.
Father?
Father?
No, you're not my father.
Peter! Peter!
The ring!
Right, sorry.
Are you the author?
It's really the rabbit story. I just wrote it down.
Look, Dad, it's Peter Rabbit.
I hate that I'm the face of this.
He's a little naughty.
What?
Are you Peter?
That depends who's asking. Peter!
Stay out of trouble!
Told you he has it in for me.
He was talking to all of us.
I'm talking to you, Peter, specifically. Stay out of trouble! Trouble! Trouble!
If that's who they think I am, maybe I'd be better off without them. Oh, come on.
What are you looking at, goody goody? You're gonna turn me in?
I'm no goody goody. Apparently, I'm a baddie baddie.
Get out of here, scram! Baby, I'm
no pain. Is your name Peter Rabbit?
Yeah.
I was best friends with your dad. My name's Barnabas. You're a fierce bad rabbit, just like him.
Where are the rabbits?
Back in their burrow, snug as a bug in a rug.
I'm gonna live forever! This land.
Get back here!
Uh-oh. Spread out.
Frolic.
Yeah, I can frolic.
Yes.
else's son. I'm feeding up a little. I'm feeding up quite a bit. Oh, God. Oh, oh.
And that's why adults shouldn't do kid stuff. Ooh.
We have to bring him back.
And we will. We're a team.
He's been through hell.
We have our people on it.
They're the best.
Let's get him back.
Shh.
The American, they will be coming for him.
Where are you holding the American?
Are you willing to die to bring you back?
Where's the American?
Where's the American? I'm not playing you!
You'll never find him.
You do not want to lose another man.
Back, he
dies. We don't go back. He dies.
Welcome to American Radium. You are paid 1 cent per dial.
Your work suffers, Miss Cavallo. The eight looks like a fat toddler.
This month's top painter, Josephine Cavallo.
Will you help me practice my feeling spaces?
I'm studying.
I have to be ready to be discovered and go to Hollywood.
I want to find a tomb like Tut's, and I'm an archaeologist.
Joe, will you be ready in 5 minutes?
Joe?
Don't come in, please.
Joe? I don't know what's wrong with her.
I'm dizzy. My joints ache. I lost a tooth and two others are loose. Do you know what's wrong with me?
Absolutely nothing. You're healthy as a horse.
Where do you work?
American Radium.
You're dial painters. We believe that exposure to radium can cause devastating tissue damage.
Radium is good for you. Everyone knows that.
What does this mean for us?
We take American Radium down.
There's a doctor that can test if your bones are radioactive.
Jesse, you sound crazy. I'm not losing my job over this. I'm scared.
I'm not going back in there.
I'm looking for Bessie and Josephine Cavallo. They did a study years ago.
They own it.
Own research?
That's absurd.
It's like owning gravity. American Radium is denying the harmful effects of radium.
All they have to do is run out the clock.
They could drag this out for years.
We don't have years.
You'll never win.
I'm doing it, no matter what.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Everyone put down your brushes. Radium is poison.
Bessie, you're trespassing.
I won't abandon you.
They're trying to silence you. They must be stopped.
You really think you can beat American Radium?
I am going to make American Radium pay for what they've done.
Tell them! Yeah.
Get Joe out of here right now!
As important as 2008 was, 2010 was to be a more important election. 2010 is a census year, and we redistrict every state and congressional seat following the census.
You win state legislatures in 2010, you get to draw the new maps that control all the elections over the next decade.
The winner is pre-decided just by the way that the districts are drawn.
Even under the scenario of the Democrats winning the vote by the biggest margin they've ever won in modern Wisconsin history, the Republicans would still get 59 seats minimum. That's an astonishing manipulation of democracy.
Congress would never fix this problem because they have one interest only, and this is to stay in power.
It's the biggest heist in modern American political history.
I'm Katie Fahey. I'm with an organization called Voters Not Politicians. We started from a Facebook post.
I saw that there was a pent-up energy, so I just thought I'd, try.
First there was 10,000, then there was 20,000, and this thing just sparked.
We're working with the anti-gerrymandering drive.
They're absolutely worried about us. They know that once this gets on the ballot, it almost always passes.
This is going to be the battlefield moving forward. If they lose, it's no holds barred.
There will be a vicious fight by the people who are in power.
We are seeing efforts to undermine the very core values of American democracy.
This may be the last time we have an opportunity to do something about partisan gerrymandering.
The people of our country are sick of this, and if we don't come and say that enough is enough, then nothing's gonna change.
What do you do?
Detective.
You look like every detective ever.
Oh, yes? How?
He's got the greasy hair and the earring. Looks good. You look good.
What about you?
What?
What do you do?
Potential tragedy strikes Critica County today as law enforcement have yet to make any headway on the missing child that vanished from Kathman Park this morning.
So you're asking me to go off this theory you got about a white married male who happens to be a father living in the suburbs of Critica County, who also happens to be your AA sponsor, has been secretly running around cramming objects, animals, and children up his ass. Then he somehow digests them, and he does this in sprees, almost in serial killer fashion. Is that about it?
Uh-huh.